want to talk to you about minimum wage, because yes, there have been people protesting against Walmart saying you should raise, you know, you should raise your minimum wage here. There have been McDonald's. I mean, over the course of the summer, there were a lot. We're hearing, we know the president wants to raise the minimum wage, I believe, to $10 an hour. There's been talk from Harry Reid. Whenever I hear talk in Congress about raising the minimum wage, I think, oh, election year, everybody's right. looking for an issue. Right. But this has more of a ring to it this time, a seriousness to it. Am I wrong?
No, because wages are stagnant, Candy. And the reason why I think there's a lot of focus on Walmart is that Walmart annual profits exceed that of 140 countries. People believe that Walmart should pay its employees a living wage. They should get better benefits, and they should not rely on federal benefits. Kevin talked about the federal government. Many of these workers have to rely on food stamps, housing assistance, and other social safety net programs. So there's a reason why, and they will not allow their workers to organize. That's why people are focusing on Walmart and all of these other corporations.
But yet corporations have duties to stockholders, right. Which, you know, I'm sure there's 401ks involved of people that are not necessarily rich. And it is kind of a balance of things when you look at these corporations as to who they're. Now, these are very wealthy owners. I mean, I'm not trying to undermine that at all.
Any company that's throwing off, you know, $17 billion in annual profit like Walmart is going to be a sitting duck for this kind of criticism, particularly when medium household income continues to be about 8% down since the growth that is since the start of 2009 or so. So as long as we have high underemployment along with unemployment, you know, these kinds of jobs are never going to be not only sustainable, but they're always going to be a political sitting duck.
Yeah. And they are, Kevin, because, you know, this goes to the growing gap between the very rich and the poor, and the idea that someone could work hard full time and still be below the poverty level or near it and needing federal assistance seems wrong to a lot.
Right, and a lot of times it becomes about the big question here is economic opportunity and how we address it. Oftentimes when you have the federal government or others step in and they start to raise the federal, or they start to raise the minimum wage, what happens is you take away or reduce some people's opportunity to grab that bottom rung of the economic ladder, to get the opportunities and the skills that you need to move up that economic ladder.
Still not
the other part of
jobs,
it, the
though.
Other part of it is the larger economic opportunity, which is, are we going to address it just through the minimum wage, or are we going to do it with much more fundamental reforms that the economy needs in order to grow, so that not only do wages increase, but also the greater economic opportunity across the spectrum of the economy, so that there are more jobs out there that are paying better. And I think that's right now where we're seeing this incredible economic exasperation out there, not only for the middle class, but of course the lower middle class. And that's something right now that we haven't seen improve over the last few years. And it's not just about Congress, but it's the administration's policy.